In this video, we are going to talk about how to solve a homogeneous differential equation. So let's start with an example. But before that, if you are new to this channel, I make videos on mathematics and civil engineering courses. So consider subscribing to this channel if you are searching for this kind of content by clicking the red subscribe button under this video that says subscribe. Okay, so now let's take a look at an example. So let's say we want to solve the differential equation 2s plus y ds is equals to, not equal to, sorry for that, minus s dy is equal to 0. So we want to solve this differential equation. Now, what makes this an homogeneous ordinary differential equation? Now notice that every term has the same degree. As you can see, every term has the same degree. 2s has the degree of 1, y has a degree of 1, s has a degree of 1. So this is what we know as the first order degree. Okay, so this is what we know as the first order degree. So the degree has to be the same for each term in order for it to be homogeneous. So as you can see, this is a homogeneous differential equation because every term has the same degree. It could be 2, 3, 4, it doesn't matter. All you need to know is that all terms, they need to have the same degree, okay, in order for it to be homogeneous differential equation. So let's evaluate this. Now what you need to do is you need to replace y with v and s. Okay, so you are going to say y is equal to v s. So whenever you see y, I'm going to replace it with vs. Now what I'm going to do is we are going to differentiate y equals to vs using product rule. Okay, so this is what you need to know. You are going to differentiate y equals to vs using product rule. So this is going to be dy is equal to, so using product rule, okay, so you are going to say the derivative of the first value dv, then multiply by the second value, then plus the first value, then multiply by the derivative of the second value. Okay, so now let's replace this. So wherever you see y, you're going to replace it with this, and wherever you see dy, you're going to replace it with these values. Okay, so now this is going to be 2s then plus y. What is y? Y is vs, so this is plus vs, then multiply by ds, then minus s dy. So what is dy? So dy is this value, so we are going to replace this value with dy. Okay, so sorry, you are going to replace dy with these values. So this is going to be s, then multiply by s dv plus v ds. Okay, then this is going to be equal to 0. So now, what we are going to do is, we are now going to evaluate this. So we are going to evaluate these values. So how can we evaluate these values? We're going to take this value, we're going to move it to the right side. Okay, so this is 2s plus vs ds. So this is equal to s multiply s dv plus v ds. Okay, so now what we are going to do is we are going to simplify this value on the left side. And how can we do this? We are going to take out the common term. As you can see, the common term here is s, so we are going to factor out the common term. So this is going to be s then multiply 2 ds, okay, then plus v multiply ds. So basically ds is going to multiply everything inside this parenthesis. Okay, and after that you are going to simplify the common term, which is s. So this is going to be equal to s then multiply s dv plus v ds. So as you can see, if we divide both sides by s, the s are going to cancel out. So the s on the right side is going to cancel out the s on the left side. Okay, so we are now left with 2ds then plus vds is equal to s dv plus vds. So now what we're going to do next is we are going to subtract both sides by vds. As you can see, we have vds on the left side, we also have vds on the right side. So if we subtract both sides by vds, we are going to cancel out the vds on the left and the vds on the right. So doing that, we are going to get 2ds, then this is equal to s dv. Okay, so now what we're going to do now is we need to separate the variables. Okay, we need to separate these variables, and how can we do this? We are going to divide both sides by s. Okay, so I'm going to say 2ds on the left side divided by s is equal to s dv divided by s. Okay, so now this is going to be 2 over s ds is equal to, as you can see, the s are going to cancel out, so we're now left with dv. Now the next step you are now going to take is we are going to integrate both sides. So we're not going to use integral to integrate both sides. As you can see, on the left side we have just the variable s, and on the left side we have just the variable v. Okay, so now we can use integral to evaluate this. So this is going to be the integral of 2 over s ds on the left side is equal to the integral of dv. Okay, now as you can see, we are having a constant. As you can see, we are having a constant inside this integral, so we can take out the constant. Okay, so this is going to be 2 then multiply by the integral of 1 over s ds, then this is equal to the integral of dv. So what is the integral of 1 over s? The integral of 1 over s is basically ln of the absolute value of s, or you can say ln of s. Okay, so this is going to be 2 then multiply by ln of s. Okay, then this is equal to, so what is the integral of dv? So this is basically saying what is the integral of 1. Okay, so the integral of 1 with respect to v is going to give us v. Okay, because we are having the variable v, so this is going to be equal to v. Then you need to include your constant c, okay, because we are dealing with indefinite integral, so you need to include your constant c. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we need to clean up our solution. Okay, so we need to clean up this solution. Now if you remember, we said y is equal to vs. As you can see, we said y is equal to vs, right, initially. So now since we don't have y, we don't have s, now we want to solve for v. So basically what we can do is we can basically say v is equal to y over s. Okay, so wherever we see v, we are going to replace it with y over s. So this is going to be 2 ln of s. So this is 2 ln of s is equal to y over s then plus c. So now what we can do is we are going to multiply both sides by s. Okay, so if we multiply both sides by s, we are going to get s multiplied 2 ln of s is equal to, so as you can see, the s is going to cancel out here, then we are having just y then plus c s. Okay, so now what we need to do, we just need to arrange this, because now we are solving for y. So if we take cs to the left side, this is going to be y is equal to s multiplied 2 ln of s then minus cs. So y is going to be equal to, so if we factor out s, which is the common term, this is going to be s then multiply by 2 ln of s then minus c. So this is basically the final answer. So this is the solution to the differential equation. So the solution to the differential equation is y is equals to s multiply 2 ln of s minus c.